Chief Meteorologist Bill Meck is also here in Carlisle getting a first-hand look at the damage and talking about exactly how this flash flooding unfolded. Bill.
Nancy, it's really amazing. When you look at Brushy Fork Creek, which is right back here, and it's a normally very placid little stream. It cuts along the edge of the town of Carlisle. Now, all the surrounding hills funneled down into this creek. It's hard to believe, though, that last Thursday night and Friday morning, this little tiny creek was actually above this bridge. And the end result was obviously horrific. How did it happen? We put down essentially a month and a half's worth of rain in 2 hours, and that happened here in Carlisle. We knew going into last Thursday night that somebody somewhere around was going to get a lot of rain. There was a tropical air mass in place. What we did not know exactly was where that was going to end up being, and it still ended up being pretty scattered around the area, but it was all focused here in Carlisle. So we knew going in that there was going to be some heavy rain. At around midnight, we had our answer as to where it was going to be. It was Carlisle, and it will be forever changed. Calvin Denton is Carlisle's emergency manager.
Decided I'd go out on the front porch and just look, see, you know, how it was doing. Well, I go out and look, and I said, well, it's really coming down. Well, that was probably 11:45, something like that. And then about, like I said, about 10 minutes after 12, dispatch called me and said, we've got water coming off of Walnut Street onto East Main Street, and it's about a foot deep.
The National Weather Service knows Brushy Fork Creek and Carlisle can be a flood zone.
Brushy Fork is what we call a flash flood hotspot, and it's basically an area identified by emergency management of that county that is known to flood pretty quickly.
And small creeks like Brushy Fork and Carlisle can change quickly.
Flash flooding happens very quickly. It can happen in a matter of minutes, but it's a very quick up and down threat.
This is Brushy Fork Creek. We're not too far from where it actually rises up. The thing is, all of the surrounding hills funneled down into this creek. Last Thursday night and early Friday morning, approximately 84 million gallons of water got poured into this creek basin and caused the tragedy that we saw here in Carlisle. Andrea's advice is the same as ours. Be prepared and stay weather aware.
Have a plan to get out in time before those floodwaters reach your dwelling and threaten you or your family. And then always have more than one way to get warnings, flash flood warnings from the National Weather Service. And that can be your local TV media, that could be No Weather Radio, that could be an app on your phone. There are many sources that you can get.
Andrea is absolutely right. You need to have information sources handy and ones that can, because this was an overnight event. Now, we highly recommend the Storm Tracker weather app. It is literally one of those things that in a situation like this, it could indeed save your life by providing you the necessary warnings while you're asleep. So, Nancy, it was a horrible tragedy and one that's hopefully never repeated. We don't ever want to see something like this again. We'll send it back up to you.